Hello students, today we will be dealing with the bases, with their classification and the properties of these bases. So the very first thing, we are going to start with the definition of these bases. Now if I talk about the definition given by Arrhenius, then according to Arrhenius, bases are defined as those substances which gives hydroxyl ion, that is OH1- ion. This hydroxyl ion, if a substance releases this hydroxyl ion in its aqueous solution, that is termed as a base. For example, if I talk about sodium hydroxide NaOH, so when it is added in water, we take the aqueous solution of this, that can be written like by the symbol Aq. So in the aqueous solution, it ionizes to give sodium cation and hydroxyl anion. Since this sodium hydroxide in its aqueous solution, it gives hydroxyl ion, that is why it can be taken as an example of base. On the other hand, if I talk about potassium hydroxide, so when we take the aqueous solution of this potassium hydroxide, it again ionizes to give potassium cation and hydroxyl anion, and since it also gives hydroxyl ion in its aqueous solution, it can also be termed as a base. Sometimes if the substance is not soluble in water, so we can also give a different definition for this base. Like base is defined as a substance which when react with an acid, formation of salt and water occurs. Like if I have the formula of FeOH whole thrice, that is ferric hydroxide. If I make this ferric hydroxide react with this phosphoric acid with the formula H3PO4. So by the reaction between these two, resultant the formation of FePO4 occurs with the formation of 3 molecules of water. Now since this iron hydroxide by the reaction with an acid is going to release its hydroxyl ion, and these hydroxyl ions are resulted in the formation of water, that is why this ferric hydroxide can be taken as an example of base. So in short, we can define these bases as the substances which contain replaceable hydroxyl ions. So bases are those substances which contain replaceable hydroxyl ions. Now if I talk about the classification of these bases, now this classification of bases can be done on different bases, and the very first classification that we are going to deal is on the basis of solubility in water. On the basis of their solubility in water, these bases are divided in two categories. As the name indicates, this out of total number of available bases, some will be soluble in water and the another one will be not soluble in water. So this can be divided in two categories. The very first category is water soluble bases, and the second category is water insoluble bases. So on the basis of their solubility in water, all the bases can be divided in two categories, whether they will be soluble in water or they will not be soluble in water. For example, if I talk about potassium hydroxide, that is KOH, so it readily dissolves in water. On the other hand, sodium hydroxide, it also dissolved in water, and since these are soluble in water, these are dissolved in water, they are termed as water soluble bases. On the other hand, if I talk about ferric hydroxide, that is FeOH whole thrice, or if I take the example of cupric hydroxide, that is CuOH whole thrice, these two bases are not soluble in water. So these are categorized as water insoluble bases. Now these water soluble bases, they have a very specific term. A very specific term is used for these water soluble bases, and these are also termed as alkanes. So that's the common name for these water soluble bases, and instead of the term water soluble bases, we generally prefer the term alkalis for these water soluble bases. So that's the very first classification, and this classification was on the basis of their solubility in water. Now the next classification of these bases is on the basis of their strength. So that's the second kind of classification, and that is on the basis of strength. Now on the basis of strength, bases can be categorized in two categories. The very first category is termed as strong bases, while the second category is termed as weak bases. Strong bases are termed as those bases which goes for the complete ionization, Like if I take the 100 molecule of any base and all these 100 molecules, if by the ionization provides hydroxyl ions, then this base which goes for the complete ionization are termed as strong bases. On the other hand, if a base goes for the incomplete or the partial ionization, like if I am taking 100 molecules of a base and out of these 100, only 5 to 10 molecules of base are there which releases hydroxyl ion, while another rest 95 to 90 molecules of bases are not going to release their hydroxyl ions, then these bases which goes for incomplete ionization are termed as weak bases. So the definition for this is bases which show complete ionization are termed as strong bases. On the other hand, if a base goes for incomplete or partial ionization, then this kind of base is termed as weak base. So that's the classification on the basis of their strength. Now we will be dealing with the next classification, that is on the basis of concentration. Now, on the basis of the concentration of a base or alkali, these are classified in two categories. The very first category is concentrated base or concentrated alkali. And the second category is termed as dilute alkali. Here, I am not using the term bases here since we are talking about the concentration in their aqueous solution. And only those bases which will be soluble in water, These terms will be used for those bases, and these water soluble bases are termed as alkalis. So on the basis of concentration, they are classified in two categories, concentrated alkali and dilute alkali. Now if an alkali contain relatively high percentage of hydroxyl anion in its aqueous solution, this kind of solution of this alkali is termed as concentrated alkali. So, if the solution contains relatively high percentage of hydroxyl ion, this will be termed as concentrated alkali, while the solution of alkali which contain relatively low percentage of alkali in its aqueous solution, this will be termed as dilute solution of this alkali. That is termed as dilute alkali. So that's the third classification, and this classification is about the concentration of hydroxyl anion in its aqueous solution. Now we will be dealing with the next classification, and this next classification of bases is on the basis of their acidity. This classification of bases on the basis of acidity, before we move for this classification, first of all we need to know what do we mean by acidity here. So when we talk about the acidity of any base, it represents the number of replaceable hydroxyl anion released by one molecule of a base. For example, if I talk about sodium hydroxide, so here we can see that the sodium hydroxide, one molecule of the sodium hydroxide contain only one hydroxyl anion. That is why it will release only one hydroxyl anion, one hydroxyl ion whenever it will participate in a reaction. Resultant, its acidity is taken as 1. On the other hand, if I talk about ferrous hydroxide, that is FeOH whole twice, so since it contains two hydroxyl group in its formula, it can release two hydroxyl anion whenever it will participate in a reaction. Resultant, its acidity is taken as 2. On the other hand, if I talk about aluminium hydroxide with the formula AlOH whole thrice, since it contains 3 hydroxyl ions in the formula, it can release 3 hydroxyl ion whenever it is added in water or whenever it participates with an acid in a chemical reaction. It gives 3 hydroxyl anion, that is why its acidity is 3. So here we can see that this value of acidity can vary. Some bases are there which releases only one hydroxylan ion, some releases two hydroxylan ion, and other releases three hydroxylan ion. That is why these, on the basis of acidity, these bases are termed as monoacidic bases. Monoacidic bases, here this mono indicates the term one, and acidic, it indicates the acidity of that base. So if the acidity of that base is 1, that will be termed as monoacidic base. On the other hand, if the acidity of any base is 2, that for example, if I talk about ferric hydroxide, or if I take magnesium hydroxide, that is MgOH whole twice, commonly known as milk of magnesia, or we take slaked lime, that is CaOH whole twice, all these three molecules of bases contains two replaceable hydroxyl anion each. That is why these are termed as diacidic bases. And diacidic bases are those bases which has the value of acidity as 2. On the other hand, if the value of acidity is 3, it contains 3 replaceable hydroxyl anion, the base is termed as triacidic base. And this category will be termed as triacidic bases. So this aluminium hydroxide is one example of this triacidic base. And that is the next classification, on the basis of acidity. Here we can see that on the basis of acidity, acids can be classified in, on the basis of acidity, bases can be classified in three categories. The very first category is of monoacidic base. Second category is termed as diacidic base, while the third category is termed as triacidic. So that's about the classification of bases. Now next time we will be dealing with the physical and the chemical properties of these bases.